Welcome to another episode of
Rhythm and Wit.
My name's Dave.
And I'm Nick.
And we're here at the Farmers Public Market of Oklahoma City for 405 Fest.
Yeah, man. The largest indoor festival in Oklahoma City.
Yeah, music and fashion and art. Yep. It's a really fun, I think, a combination of really interesting things. And all locally made. I think Farmers Market, obviously, they do their weekly Farmers Market here and sell a lot of locally grown produce, so they continue that tradition by having local art and fashion and all kinds of things.
Yeah, but today, it's the 405 Fest.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they've got over 50 plus vendors. They've got a fashion show that's gonna happen, and they also have music and performances, and it's gonna be fun.
A lot of local bands. We just saw Pineapple Willows play. They're great. We're gonna see some more. I think Dinosaur Boyfriend is another one I'm interested in seeing. And then there's one later tonight I'm gonna try to stick around for, by the name of Nia Monet.
Okay, yeah, I saw that.
R&B artist. I've never seen her perform, so definitely want to try to stick around just to see her and hopefully talk to her.
Absolutely. Get some interviews, talk to some vendors.
We're definitely going to talk to some interesting like people in there. So, yeah, we're excited about this. I've been looking forward to this for a few weeks now, so excited to be here. Anything that you saw in there so far that piqued your interest or maybe a vendor or anything like that?
Yeah, I'm excited to learn. You know, a lot of I never really go to fashion shows.
Yeah.
I've absolutely been to zero.
Yeah.
So like, I'm super excited to come in. I wore my best clothes, so I'm hoping to find better ones. And
maybe find get some fashion tips from some of the people.
Yeah. And this is the place to do it.
Yeah.
Yeah. They curated specifically for this show, so it's pretty fun. We're gonna go around, look at some cool shirts. Dave's gonna get some great pics, and then I think we got a visitor. Liz might be coming.
Okay.
She says she's on her way. So hey, why don't you guys come with us and we'll check it out.
Yeah, for sure. All right, let's go inside.
Yeah.
Give it time.
Hey, how's it going? Ed, introduce yourselves, let everybody know who you are.
I am Dante, the lead singer and guitarist of Pineapple Willows. Name's Dylan, play bass and co-lead singer, Pineapple Willows,
correct.
I guess.
Yeah,
a lot of talent in one band.
Yeah.
A lot of lead singers.
A lot of sass.
How'd you like it? How'd you like playing at the festival?
Oh, it's super fun. We did it last year. He had just joined right after we got done, but it was fun last year. There were a lot of people that came out, a lot of people danced. It was very nice, and I'm just happy to be here again.
Nice. So you've only been together for about a year. You joined in?
Kind of. We started the band together, and I left for probably about three, four years, something like that.
Oh, wow.
I didn't rejoin until 2023 of last year. And we started like 2019, like pre-Kobe Bryant death.
What brought you back?
I was in a better mindset, better financial state. Yeah, and so I'd really been, music had been itching me, and I was like, man, I think I'm ready to rejoin.
That itch.
And so, yeah.
How'd you guys prepare for the show? How'd you guys get ready?
Coors Light. And
yeah.
Just laughing.
Yeah.
That's all I
see. Normally I'm a little anxious. I still get stage fright sometimes. It takes about a song or two until I like kind of calm down.
Yeah.
So sometimes getting that like little tiny little buzz. I don't do it every time, but you know, maybe a Michelob and a half is normally when I'm in my like green zone.
Yeah.
And so I hit the green zone, I think. A little bit.
Congrats. It's a delicate balance.
Correct. Yeah.
I couldn't even tell you were nervous up there.
Oh, I always.
You guys were great.
Always.
Yeah. Sounded real good too.
Thank
you. I think I saw you guys a while back. I listened to you on Spotify. And I was pretty blown away, man. You know,
thanks,
the local talent here just keeps getting better and better. You know? Especially you, Dante. Your voice is killing it. You're doing
Thank
great.
You.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I love his voice personally. His is my favorite.
Yeah, no, it's good. See, it's good to have favorites within the band.
That's true.
When you think about leaving again,
right?
Remember
correct.
That.
But yeah, that's what's so fun about playing these shows. Is I just like meeting all the new bands and like all these people I haven't heard of or haven't gotten the chance to meet and listen to and stuff. And so.
And we had fans after the Pride Fest. They came up to us and they wanted like our autographs. And it was like, oh my God, hi.
Oh yeah.
Can we take your picture too?
Getting a high five from a stranger like makes the show worth it. Like that's awesome, man. As long as people are tapping their foot, like. We're good.
Yeah. Well, this being a fashion show, a fashion festival as well, do you have any fashion tips for everyone out there?
Ooh. Wear what you like. Wear what you like. It doesn't matter. You're going to die one day. Wear what you like.
That's true. Yeah. If there's something you want to wear or you're thinking about wearing, just like, you know, kind of subtly get into it.
Get into
it. I was like, for a septum ring, I didn't want that at first, and I was like, I don't know if it'll look good on me or whatever, and I eventually just like, oh, screw it, I like it, let's get it. And then, and now I'm wearing cut-off shorts. So.
Yeah, dude.
Most of the time, it's crop tops with us.
Yeah, I see you getting out there experimenting, putting yourself out there. How do you make those decisions? What inspired you?
Like, fashion?
Yes. Yeah.
Oh, fuck. I don't know, just, it feels like it's me. It feels like me being myself.
I like that.
And I don't care what anyone thinks. I'm the one on stage performing these songs that you guys like. It's like, I'm going to wear what I want, you know?
Yeah, I love it.
You know?
Yeah, you got a peacock a little bit.
Yeah, I'm a big vintage guy. Like, I like wearing stuff that I think kind of like represents what inspires me. So like, I'm wearing a Wallow shirt right now. And so they were actually opened up with a Wallow song. And so they're, you know, the kind of stuff like that. I don't know what exactly the shorts remind me of. But
youth. Maybe, yeah.
Yeah, maybe. Before I loved the Beatles, spoiler alert, I was a big Van Halen fan. Van Halen was my first favorite band of all time. I had a Four Seasons phase in high school.
Oh, yeah.
Beatles came first, but I don't know, that mid, like, that hair metal fashion phase where, like, you know, it's like the short shorts, it's the crops, it's like the really skinny, like, coked out guitarists, and like, I love that, man.
Yeah.
So that's
dedication, really.
Exactly.
Dedication to the crop.
I won't do coke, but like,
valid, same thing.
Yeah, no, that's beautiful, man. I love it. Where can everybody find you?
Anywhere you type in Pineapple Willows on Google, that'll lead you to everything you need. Spotify, Apple Music, iTunes, whatever you got, Instagram, TikTok. We got a TikTok. We do. It's pretty fun. So anywhere you can find us, just type in Pineapple Willows, like the fruit and like the tree.
Yeah. And we got a single August 9th for Waitress. It should be accompanied by a music video that like a bunch of OU film students shot.
Oh, my God.
Our drummer had some good connections.
So talented.
That, like, you can hate the song. The video is killer.
The video
is
good.
It's actually insane. Then the EP comes out, I think, late August, early September, I think.
Yeah.
I think.
To be determined.
To be determined.
Somewhere around there, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then the video.
August 9th.
You should come out with the single. We're excited about that song. We really like that song.
Also, I hear that you guys might be playing a show September 20th at the venue. Is that correct?
That sounds about right.
Yeah,
yes.
I think that's a rock comedy show that I'm producing.
Whoa!
Well, we hope to see you guys out there.
We'll see you.
Thank you so much. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Nick. I'm distracted by the performances here.
Oh yeah, for sure. So let everybody know who you are and what you do.
Sure. My name is Evin Jarvik. I run a thing called Make Oklahoma Weirder, and we're really into local music. If you're doing stuff that's original, kind of left of field, not your typical oaky music, we really want to find out about it and tell other people about it. And that's kind of the mission. And then it has manifested itself into a whole myriad of different ways, including sometimes showing up to these vending events.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
How long have you been doing it?
Make Oklahoma Weirder started in 2018. I've been involved in the local scene for longer than that, but that's when I officially decided to start a blog in 2018, and then it became a whole bunch of other things. But I guess 6 years.
Yeah, six years. That's a long run. That's pretty good, man.
Yeah, we made it through the pandemic. So.
Yeah. Is there anybody you're excited to see here tonight?
Man, it's a really stacked lineup they got here. I'm not clued into the fashion scene, so I'm really curious to see the runway show here in a little bit. But in terms of music, the dark skinned rapper is going to be on later, who I'm excited to see because I've never seen any of the O2 Worldwide hip hop members, and that's one of the few that like have gone solo that I've like still kind of kept some tabs on. So I'm really curious to see him. I believe Dinosaur Boyfriend's going to be on.
if I'm not mistaken. There's like a big lineup here. Is Neil Monet on this?
Yeah.
Yeah, Neil Monet's great. You never quite know what she's gonna bring. Yeah, there's a lot of cool stuff. But I would probably say the dark skin rapper is the one that I really am excited about.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah. So do you go out to shows often? How do you keep up with the local?
I want to go to all the shows, and I can't physically do that. There's so many. But I do a lot of research. I've really gamed my social media algorithms so that they feed me all the shows. And I know how to, like, follow the different artists and the different venues so that if I need to go look stuff up, I know what's happening and when. We do weekly show recommendations, as you know, which we appreciate the shout-outs that you've given us over the months. But yeah, I don't make them out to as many as I would like to, but when I do, it's really great, and I try and just be in that moment and just really get to know an artist on a more intimate basis, which I think you can really do in a local music scene. Like when you're literally, like I saw a local man Ruins Everything last week, and I was literally like, I don't know, 3 feet away from the band. And they're just like phenomenal musicians, and just being able to like appreciate that level of artistry in such an intimate setting is so rare. And so, yeah, I do all that stuff.
Yeah, I love that, dude. I love that. It's inspiring to see you get into it like that. I feel the same way about the comedy scene.
Yeah.
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 So what do you got going on here? What do you got selling? What are you giving away?
Well, let's see. We've got. So I mean, we're here first and foremost just to like get the word out. Say, hey, if you're into local music. This is some local music that we have. This right here, these are Umami zines from our local library system, the Metropolitan Library. The archive, the underground music archive that they run, puts out a monthly zine with a live music calendar and local articles and stuff. I'm a contributor. I write just about one thing every issue. And so they're totally free into the public, so I always try and grab a bunch of them and just pass them around to everybody. Over here are cassette tapes. These are 100% local artists, brand new music put out on cassettes. A lot of people are still amazed that cassettes have been making this comeback, but we have all this stuff is original stuff. I've even got some Chat Pile tapes in here that I brought especially for the occasion because they always sell out so fast that I just can't keep them in stock, but I brought them here. The brand new Free Association album, Country Gold album, that's an exclusive that you can't get anywhere else. I actually know the composer who wrote the soundtrack for Country Gold, which is a Mickey Reese film about Garth Brooks, and it has one of the best closing credit songs ever, and none of it's available on streaming. There's more here. I've got an 8-track tape over here by a Tulsa band called Broken Vacuum. I always bring it out, nobody ever buys it, but I like to have it around. I got a couple of vinyls from Scissortail up in Tulsa. There's a really great improv duo that does kind of like an Indian meets Tulsa sound. And then everything else is just merch. So if you want to support what we do, like I don't make any money off of it. Everything we make goes right back into it. I'm sure a lot of creatives out here understand what that's like, including y'all. But we've got shirts and hats and stickers. And for back to school, we got pencils, which they're teacher approved. We've literally given them out to teachers, and we've had them come back and say, these are some of the best pencils. So that's been really cool. So yeah, that's kind of what we do. We're also going to be back. I mean, whenever this goes up, this is all going to be old news, but we're also going to be at the Punk Rock Flea Market on Sunday at Blue Note. But also, if you happen to be tuning in from Tulsa, check us out at the Tulsa Punk Rock Flea Market. We're going to be there later this year. And then the Cassette Week is coming up in October. They just announced the official dates for Cassette Week. So it's October 14th through the 20th. So if you're into this whole tape thing and you want a chance to win a brand new tape player, like a really fancy Bluetooth modern one, we're going to be doing a giveaway come October. So.
Oh, good. Hey, why is tapes making a resurgence?
I got a lot of theories on it.
Yeah.
I think first and foremost, analog audio is just, I think it's something that we lost touch with at some point. Like convenience became such a big factor that we kind of stopped learning how to appreciate music on its own terms. and everything became fast food convenience. And so whenever you intentionally go out and buy an album, whether it's a vinyl or a CD or a tape, I think it really has a specific specialness to it, and you have a sense of ownership that you don't get when everything's on streaming and things can disappear all the time. Specifically with tapes, as opposed to CDs, it's not like MP3 files, it's actual audio tape, it's actually analog. You know, it does degrade over time. It's like a very special, some would say archaic, but I think it's organic. I really like just kind of like the texture of it. And tapes are way more affordable than vinyl, which is why we tend to focus on tapes, and why a lot of bands will put stuff out on tapes as opposed to vinyl. Not only is vinyl incredibly expensive, and you have to like make at least 100 of them if you're going to make any order whatsoever, but it's also just lost my train of thought. But tapes are, I just think they're more for the people in a sense.
Yeah.
And like you can literally make like 5 at a time or 10 at a time. And as a band, like you don't have to worry about this investment. Oh, that's what I was gonna say. So many of the vinyl manufacturers shut down whenever vinyl went out that now there's only a handful that make them. And when you have somebody like infamously Taylor Swift single-handedly put like an entire bottleneck in the vinyl industry, because she would make so many different variations of her records on vinyl, that little indie artist who just wanted to get a handful of records made would have to wait like over a whole year just to get a vinyl pressing done. So it's really difficult to make vinyl work. It's also something you have to be really, really, really careful with to preserve that quality, as opposed to tapes, which I think are almost kind of meant to kind of age and deteriorate a little bit, which personally I really like. And I think especially when we live, this is a long answer, but
no, you're going, man. You're good.
Like, I mean, VHS is also coming back.
Yeah.
Like there's, it's not even a nostalgic thing. It's like a younger generation who didn't even grow up with it. And they're, it's like, oh wow, there's something that used to exist that has this kind of analog feel. And it's just, it's not sterile. It's like real. And I think people really appreciate that. Like analog horror is a really big thing. Like on YouTube, you know? And it's that aesthetic, the aesthetic of something that's kind of from another time, but is still somehow relevant, but it's aged in a certain way, and there's just like a mystery about it. Like, I feel like you lose all of that whenever everything is just on streaming platforms.
Yeah.
And obviously I use streaming platforms, but there's something special about just buying a single album on a single tape, putting it in, not being able to skip tracks, like you just listen to it front to back. And I just think it's a really special and intimate way to connect with music in a way that it's not convenient per se, but there's a trade-off there that I think people find it worthwhile. It's maybe even the lack of convenience that makes it, like you know it's special if you're gonna go out of your way to get like a chat pile tape. Which Chatpile just announced a new album, if you didn't know.
Okay.
So if you're big on that Chatpile wagon, we already pre-ordered some tapes. So come looking for us in October for Cassette Week. We're going to have a limited number of those Chatpile tapes.
Beautiful. Where can people find you?
Cool World is the new album. People can find us at MakeOklahomaWeirder.com or on social media at WeirderOK. We do show recommendations, other stuff. We have events we put on ourselves as well. So if you're just interested in everything that we do, Instagram's probably the most popular place for us right now. But we're also on Facebook. We're on X for now. Instagram's probably the best place right now. Weirder OK. Make Oklahoma Weirder. We got some stuff in the works. Also, I have a podcast with KOSU now, so check out KOSU.org, go to their podcast page. I do a weekly podcast where I talk about a different local artist every single week and play one of their songs, and one of them was literally just on stage. So, it's been cool to have that radio segment that has become a podcast. So shout out to Ryan LaCroix and the team over at KOSU for giving me a more elevated platform to reach more people with local music.
So. Yeah. Well, Jarvis, thanks so much. It was great. Thank you for everything you do too, man. Really appreciate it.
Thanks for chasing me down.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, and you guys remember, you heard it here first. Taylor Swift is the reason why vinyl is dead. Okay.
Thank you.
Hey, man. Hey, I'm Nick. All right. Hey, how's it going?
Going good. How are you?
Doing well. Hey, will you introduce yourself to everybody?
Hi, my name is Cyan Houston. I'm from OKC. This is all my work. I work with charcoal, oil paint, digital, everything there is.
How long you been working at it?
I started when I was 19. I'm now 24, so 5 years.
What mediums do you like to work in?
I love charcoal. This is what got me started. You can make so many mistakes, just erase it, wipe it away.
Yeah.
And this has got to be the hardest. This is Sharpie. One mistake and it's over.
That's really? It goes all over? Yeah. I really like this one right here.
Thank you so much. That's oil pastel.
Okay.
Go-Go from Kill Bill.
So this being a festival, a fashion festival, do you have any fashion tips for us?
Fashion tips? Do what you want. Express yourself. Fashion is another form of art, so self-expression is really where it's at. And it's not fun.
How do you do that for yourself?
I'm obsessed with blue. I got some blue right here, so it's pretty much all I wear, and that's how I express my favorite color. Gone through life, anything blue catches my eye, so
I like that.
I wear blue all the time.
Blue is my favorite color too.
Nice.
It's royal blue, you know. So where can everybody find you?
Right here, actually. Cy Houston on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok. I'm all over. You can even catch me in the streets sometimes.
Well, thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Thank you so much. It's a great time. Big fight, but stand new clip on it. Damn right, I'm all I got that bitch on me. Get wrong, I let it sing like this on me. Ooh, I'm just being honest, nigga. All I wanna do is get the money, nigga. And I cannot bounce for nobody but I cannot depend on nobody but God. See all this pain when you look in my eyes. Open your tongue if you're trying to survive. I do want to maintain, and I'm sick and tired of going through the same thing. It's a good game. Money, you can have a friend. Yeah. I ain't never had enough. Spend my whole life trying to have some. Yeah. I just want to maintain. Sick and tired of going through the same thing. Yeah. You can beef if you want to. You can sleep if you want to. But I'ma taste this money, this money, this money. This money, this money. I'ma taste this money, this money, this money. This money, this money, this money. You can have it.
Talk about this next design here. I had to go, my friends right here, I had to go get me a clipboard so I could see what I was reading on the paper because the light was illuminating. I'm 33 again. It's becoming a little, that older age is starting to get to me. The knees, the back, and all, it's bad. All right. Enough about me. I'm not making this about me. Girl,
Doing our thing.
Yeah, it's beautiful. Yeah. Can you introduce yourself to everybody and tell them what you do?
Man, my name is Jordan Morris. I'm an artist. I do murals all over Oklahoma. I do pop-ups all the time in the city. I'm an artist and painter, so I'm out here selling some artwork that I got going right now. Basically, my art's about bringing emotion to life, talks about daily struggles that we all go through, and I have a certain style that's become sort of recognizable in the city.
We've seen a lot of your stuff. We really appreciate your work, man.
And I'm glad to do it for you guys. As long as you guys are happy enjoying it, I'll keep doing it for y'all, you know?
Yeah, that's beautiful. How long you been at it?
Man, I'd say about a good 4 to 5 years. That's how long I've been doing like the style and like the brand. So yeah, about 4 to 5 years.
Yeah. This being a fashion festival.
Yeah.
Did you choose what you're wearing because of that?
You know, half yes, half no. I kind of just wanted to go out with a bang. I thought it'd be cool to like bring out this jean jacket. So basically this jean jacket is the leftover paint from my brushes from like 2 to 3 years of paintings. I wiped it off on this jean jacket. And I thought it'd be great to wear the 405 Fest because of the fashion and just to kind of bring something different to the art, you know?
Yeah, that's beautiful, man. Yeah. How do you find that you put your unique self and your unique artistry in your fashion or in what you wear? How do you do that? Can you give us tips on how to be unique in that way?
Man, that's a good question. I feel like my work kind of has like that street style look anyways, so I try to incorporate that into fashion the best way I can. So like either painting it on jackets or making t-shirts or bags, there's always some kind of way you can make your art into fashion, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I just simply just enjoy just painting on jackets or making clothing, you know, with my work on it.
Yeah. That's awesome.
That's a good question.
Oh, thanks. Yeah. So where can everybody find you?
Besides like pop-ups and stuff, you can find me on Instagram at @ThroughMyEyes_. My website's shopthroughmyeyes.com. Or just like I said, pop-ups in the city and like events that I do.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for your time, man. We really appreciate you.
Hey, and thank you for the opportunity. Thank you.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
Can you introduce yourself to everyone and let them know what you're vending?
My name is Han Solo, and I sell retro cameras from Polaroid point and shoots and SLRs.
Nice. How'd you get into it?
Man, it's just, I used to shoot a lot of digital cameras, and I just got tired of editing photos all the time. So I switched to shooting film, and because of those, I don't have to edit. I know you can, but it's like, you know, I just drop it off and have someone else scan and develop it for me. Like, I got to that point because I got overwhelmed with like editing videos and photos, so I got into it. And then I started posting my collection, and then people start hitting me up. Hey, is that one for sale? Like, no, it's not. I'm sorry. And then just people keep asking me if the camera is for sale, so I start selling cameras.
Nice.
For a good price. And I always price match, or I always give the best deals, because I know I can sell a camera for like, you know, more than it should worth. But that price is just like taking advantage of people who are like, learn about the camera because of YouTube, and then they just like, you know, overpay for the camera.
Yeah.
So
you work to help get them good deals for
Good deals. Yeah. Can I show an example?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. How?
319.
75 versus 319.99 motherfucking cents.
Yeah. That's great.
Look at this.
Yeah. Thank you for your service. And helping everybody.
God, that is that is fucking crazy.
So how'd you get in the 405 Fest? This is just what you take on your own.
So I used to I actually attend 405 Fest all the time.
Oh, okay.
But my streak ended at the previous one. It's because I was out of town. Yeah, I love this. Yeah. And this is my first time actually vending here.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's even better.
Yeah.
Well, hey, congrats. Thanks for talking with us.
Thank you so much. What's your name, man?
I'm Nick Campbell.
Nick?
Yes, sir.
Nice to meet you, Nick.
What would you like to, or where can everybody find you?
You can find me on Instagram at RetroCamOKC. And my personal Instagram is TumblrDaddyIRL. I know it's cringy, but I'm stuck with that name. It's because everybody knows me with that name already.
Yeah. Well, thank you. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, appreciate your sign. Good, thank you.
Thank you. you all want a t-shirt, if you want to say what's up, please say what's up. We love you.
Yeah, can we give it one more time for Dinosaur Boyfriend, please? 4 or 5 fans. We're going to be better than that. 4 or 5 fans. Can we do it one more time for Dinosaur Boyfriend, please?
All right. Hey, how's it going?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing well. I'm doing well. Can you tell us who you are and what you do?
My name's Kristen Scott. I make oddities art that's out of nature-based, so like bones, bugs, plants.
Okay. How'd you get into that?
It was through my sister. I have a twin sister, and she did a lot of it like at home with herself, and we had started, it was during COVID that I had started getting into it, and it just was really therapeutic, calming, being able to just kind of like zero in and zone out into it, and I've kind of just stuck with it since.
Nice. So how did you, so that's how you got into this medium?
Yeah.
How do you source all this stuff
so
to make it?
So some I forge myself. And then some either I buy from local vendors or out of state or out of country, depending on where it's from. So like I have like those giant moths down there. They're from Indonesia, and I had them imported.
Oh my god.
Yeah, and then that's like how a lot of them are. Some of them I find, like I had this ship from my friend in Alabama. So.
It's a very interesting type of. What does this make you feel? How do you feel?
I feel like it's a second life, chance at life for them.
Oh, I like that.
It's like finding the pretty in the afterlife kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's inevitable, so.
Do you do any other kind of art, drawing or anything?
I do drawing sometimes, but I'm not the best at sticking with it.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm saying.
Yeah. I've done painting, and I just haven't done painting in a long time.
Okay. Well, tell everybody where they can find you.
I am on Instagram, Cosmic Curiosities, and then I also have some stuff at Flora Bodega in the Plaza.
Oh, nice.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yes.
Well, it was nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you.
Appreciate it. Have a good day.
You too. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
Yeah, and we'll tag you guys.
Awesome. So I'm like, ooh, don't ask me a lot of questions about that.
Okay, all right, so avoid the boots. We don't want to do that. No boots. Okay, ready? Okay. Ready to go? All right. Hey, how's it going?
Hi, good. How are you?
Just let everybody know who you are and what you do.
Hi, I'm Dee Dee with Factory 212 Replay. It's me, my husband, and my brother-in-law. And we have a booth at Room 3 Vintage. We like mid-century modern. We like Western, anything from basically anything old. We love it, and it just kind of harkens back to like my family and just memories of days gone by that were great.
Oh, that's sweet. Yeah. Where do you get all your stuff? How do you find it?
Oh, we pick in all sorts of places. Ruben and Ralph go to the bins on occasion, Goodwill bins. So Goodwill is a great sponsor for us. And we go to estate sales, garage sales, Facebook Marketplace, like all sorts of fun places. And so many things. We've met so many amazing people and heard so many cool stories just from meeting people on Facebook Marketplace and going to their house, you know, and getting free bookshelf that was in her room from the 80s. It's so cool.
Yeah. All right. And then so you just kind of curate it by your... whatever you find that speaks to you.
Yes, yeah. Definitely. Something that we would want to put in our own house or wear on our own bodies, you know?
So you like Western wear personally as well?
My husband and my brother-in-law do. They love it. They wear the boots. I'm a Texas girl, so you would think I'd be into Western.
Yeah.
I like to see it on people, but I personally don't wear it myself, so I don't know.
Yeah.
That's messed up.
Well, what brings you to 405 Fest?
Well, we moved here from Texas, and so we're not from here, but when I saw 405 going on, it was such a cool community, like introduction to the community, and I don't know, it was just like a cool vibe.
Nice.
And we were very excited about kind of getting an opportunity to meet people this way, And obviously, it's we all have something in common, so kind of meeting people, that's really fun, and kind of showcasing what we've got. So the fashion show was amazing upstairs. That was very inspiring. I've made some of the bags. My husband and I have been like making handmade bags and things. So seeing the fashion upstairs, I was like, these are some good ideas.
Yeah, I like that. Let's see. Oh, this being a fashion festival, what are some tips you would have for people in order to up their fashion game?
Oh, man. I think obviously finding things that speak to you, and if it's not fitting you just right, alter it. Like, I mean, this shirt was awesome. I love this shirt. It was too long, so I was like, I'm just going to crop that off. So don't be afraid to chop things, even if they're vintage. And I know I'm probably going to get a lot of hate for that. But if they're vintage and true vintage and you're scared to chop it, I mean, you get one life.
Yeah.
Just make something, create something that you feel comfortable in, that makes you feel good about yourself, and rock it.
Nice. I love that. I'm going to start doing it.
Yeah, do that.
Tell everybody where they can find you.
So we've got a booth over at Room 3 Vintage. We're Factory 212 Replay, and you can find us on Instagram and Facebook at Factory 212 Replay.
All right, Dee, thank you so much.
Thank
it
you
was
so
nice
much.
To meet you.
Good to meet you too. I'm sorry.
I'm a Dragon Ball fan.
That's what's up.
Myself too.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's killer.
It was like the eighth one I ever did.
Well, hey, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
And would you like to introduce yourself to everybody and let them know what you do?
Yeah, I'm JoJo. I'm an artist. I paint primarily. I also design some fashion. I do hair, make jewelry.
A little bit of everything. Artistry in all your life?
Yes, I just, so I've been doing it for about 20 years. I started sketching when I was about 14. I'm 34 now. And so I've just been consistently just keep going.
Oh,
and then the last 2 years or so, I really put everything into it. So
I noticed that you're very inspired by old anime.
I like the old Dragon Ball. Simpsons has always been one of my things. I'm working on some Pokemon stuff right now too. And I'll be doing some Naruto as well.
What medium do you like to work in?
I'm primarily acrylic. Acrylic paint. These are all actually black light and 3D reflective, most of them.
Oh, we tried the 3D glasses.
Yeah,
it was very effective.
So a lot of those, I do like a really light layer of high flow acrylics on there. So, yeah.
This seems like magic to me. I mean, it's pretty awesome.
Yeah, so I actually did not know that I was even doing that. I had another artist come up to my table a few months ago at another event who's a 3D artist, and he was like, I want to see your stuff with my glasses. And I was like, what are you talking about? And he was like, and he did, and sure enough, so now they are a staple for sure.
So they were already 3D ready?
Yes, I didn't know that I was doing it. It just naturally, happy accidents. No, another artist brought his 3D glasses over to my table.
Todd Clark.
Yep.
Oh, that's so cool.
Yes, it was. Yes, I can thank him for sure.
Yeah, we talked to him.
He's great. He came up and he was like, I want to see your stuff. And I'm like, what?
That's awesome.
So, yeah. Thanks.
So, this being a fashion festival, do you have any tips for anybody, you know, say like me, who's looking to try to up their fashion game?
I mean, just be yourself. At the end of the day, that's the best thing.
Dad come across pretty good here?
It's great.
Yeah.
It's great.
Yeah, dude.
Totally
authority.
Great.
That's what I'm looking for right here. Hold on. Got it. I love it. Well, let everybody know where they can find you.
You can find me on my Instagram at jarmontrout2690, or you can look me up on my Etsy. My link to that is on my Instagram as well. That's right now. I do a lot of pop-ups and a lot of shows.
What's on the horizon?
Oh, man, lots of stuff. Hopefully, I wanted to get into some bigger festivals. I do a lot of stuff in the rave scene, as you see the bucket hats and the rave hair and stuff like that. So I want to get to those bigger festivals and just kind of see where it takes me.
Awesome. Well, hey, it was nice meeting
you. Nice to meet you, too.
Yeah, you have a good time.
Thank you, guys.
appreciate y'all. If y'all missed it, my name is Nia Monet, and these are the Moonrays. And this is actually our last show until the fall time. So keep an eye out for us.
Love the set. The music is beautiful. Thank you for bringing it to us. Yeah. Can you let everybody know who you are and what you do?
My name is Spot 30, and I'm a local country soul rock artist here in OKC. Been making music for 4 years, multi-genre, military veteran, and I just love to make music for real.
Yeah, man. You say you've been doing it for 4 years?
Yeah.
What got you into it?
COVID.
Yeah.
I was bored. I was living in Seattle, didn't have nothing to do, couldn't go to work. So woke up one day and decided to start making music. I've been singing in church and stuff my entire life, but I never focused on making music for myself. I've always wanted to sing for God, so I decided during that time to start making my own.
Yeah, well, you're doing great. I love it. What brought you to 405 Fest?
They reached out to me earlier this year. I guess they saw my engagement on the Instagram and stuff like that, and then they invited me to perform, so.
Yeah. So who's with you? Who's playing with you?
My band's called The Soul Collective. It's a compilation of some really dope artists in their own right. They play instruments, but they also sing. I got a guy named Calvin Skies. He's a singer and a guitarist. He also plays the piano. My drummer, John the Don, he's a dope singer and rapper at the same time. A guitar player also raps and sings. And we have my bass player. He's pretty dope. He plays the bass and guitar. And then we got a new member that we added the other day. Her name is Berta, and she also is a country artist, but decided she wanted to sing backup and also play too. So we got a movement. The Soul Collective is it's bigger than me. Right now it's 530 Soul Collective. Next show it could be Calvin Skies in the Soul Collective. It's not just my platform. I'm trying to get everybody out there.
Oh, okay. Yeah. What are the plans for the future?
Plans for the future is just to keep pushing hard and making it to the next level, getting bigger shows, bigger gigs, and better opportunities. This is a great opportunity. We want Paycom. We want to go bigger and better. Yeah. Going to Nashville in September for the first time. So that's the proving grounds for country music. We're about to show them ourselves in September.
Nice. So, where can everybody find you?
You guys can find me on all social media. It's the number 5IVE3RTY. That's 5IVE3RTY. Everywhere.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Appreciate you.